Oh, yeah, we were there when they were born, and then at age one, when they appeared on the Oprah show, and when they took their first steps and headed off to kindergarten when they became teenagers, and today it is Sweet 16 for the McCoy septuplets. Carlisle family facing a whole new set of challenges these days, for example, teaching seven teenagers to drive.
Molly Cooney had the exclusive first interview with the family after the babies were born. She's followed them through all of their milestones, and she joins us now with another big one to celebrate.
Time flies, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
I know, none of us can believe it. I couldn't believe it when I walked in there. We hadn't seen them in 3 years. They change. 16 years ago today, the eyes of the world were focused on Des Moines, Iowa, as Bobby and Kenny McCoy welcomed the world's first living septuplets. Now the septuplets are entering the world of dating, driving, and deciding what's next after high school.
From diapers to driving.
Yeah, easy. That's got to go slower on that.
From bouncing babies to teenagers texting and on iPhones, life is ever-changing inside this home in Carlisle.
Oh my gosh, how are you doing? Yeah, well, good grief, you guys. In 3 years, I can't believe this.
The last time we stopped by the McCoy septuplets, they had just turned teenagers. Now it's Sweet 16 for Kenny, Alexis, Natalie, Kelsey, Nathan, Brandon, and Joel.
Questions for the gang. Who's driving? Who's had an accident? Ooh. Who has a cell phone? Who wants a cell phone?
They're sophomores in high school, active in bands, sports, and just being teenagers, much to the delight of older sister Michaela, now at DMAC.
I like it. I like it a lot because we all get along really well, and we have the same interests now, and we're on the same level, I guess.
Who has had stitches? Who has had bad colds, been sick a lot?
All of them have.
All of them? Okay.
Not a lot.
Okay. Oh, thank you.
Parents Bobby and Kenny say it truly is Sweet 16.
Just a lot easier to, because they're more mature and, you know, doing things that, you know, like they should, I guess.
Each stage that they have gone through has been fun in its own way. But I think probably right now is what I would consider the most fun that we've had.
Who is dating? Okay. Who wants to date?
Not too embarrassing. Sorry about that, guys. Well, coming up tonight at 10, we're going to be talking with each of the Sweet 16 to find out their interests, what they want to do in 2 years after graduation, and how the parents meet the financial and emotional challenges of teenage angst times seven. I can't imagine.
Well, these seven were the most famous babies 16 years ago in the entire world. So what about the fame? Has it worn off? Has it changed them or what?
It has, and Bobby said that they expected it would. She said it lasted longer than they thought, about 10 years, but she said they knew bigger and better things would come along. So they planned for that and saved and did all that. And she said while it was wonderful and they are grateful for everything that did come their way, they don't really miss the publicity and all of the camera people and all of that. So, but the kids seem to handle everything. And Natalie, you'll hear at 10 o'clock, said it's no big deal. You know, kids grew up with us, so we're just their friends.
It's been fun to see the check back in.
Oh, I feel like, you know, the long-lost aunt. It just kind of checks in. But,
but how nice of them to let you come back every once in a while for a visit.
I didn't get cake, but that's okay. We'll work on that.
Next time.
Yeah, there you go.
Thanks, Molly.